and my father, firefighter Robert James Crawford, Safety Battalion 1, who served our country with the United States Air Force and served our city as a New York City firefighter for 32 and a half years. He was a great husband, father, brother, and friend. We love you, Daddy, to infinity and back. We will never forget you. We will always love you. And as you always said, Daddy, we got your back. God bless New York City and God bless America.
And we will not forget him or the 342 other firefighters who died at the site there at the World Trade Center attacks 10 years ago today. And HLN's Jane Velez Mitchell has been following every emotional moment, just steps from ground zero. We've really appreciated all the interviews that you've been bringing us. Some very personal stories, Jane. You're live now with three firefighters.
Yes, and they have come all the way from Hillsborough County, Florida, to pay their respects. They've traveled here, and I just saw them there, and I asked them, and they said that, well, why don't you tell us a story? Alex Graydon, one of the guys that you work with, has a brother who died here. Tell us about that.
Yes, we work with a guy named Brian Muldowney, Hillsborough County, Florida. His brother, Engine 16, Truck 7, died at 9/11, so we came up here to pay our respects.
Being here and talking to firefighters, it really reminds me of something that I never really thought about before, and that is that you risk the possibility, you face the possibility of death every day. I go to work, I don't have that issue. But every time you go to work, there's always a chance that you'd be sent into a burning building and might not come out.
It's the job. You do what you love. It just makes you appreciate everything in life every day. If I had to die, I'd choose to die in the line of duty, like those guys did.
Wow. And I understand that your wife, as a surprise, got you a ticket because she knew that you were so, so intent on being here for this 10th anniversary.
Yes, ma'am. I didn't know until 8 hours before my plane was leaving that I was coming up here. She knows how much it means to me to be a part of this and spend the best experience of my life.
And you're emotional about it.
Yes, ma'am.
It's okay. I know you're a tough guy, but it's okay to be a little emotional. What is in your heart right now?
It's hard to put it into words. You can see anything you can on TV, and once you're here, the emotions are, they run wild. It's hard to put into words.
Well, I just want to thank all of you. I know you were elected to speak for the group, but thank you for coming to New York and for doing what you do, risking your lives. And I have to say that it's given me a newfound awareness of what these guys go through every day. And when we all see firefighters coming down the street and we have to pull our cars over, we should realize that our inconvenience is absolutely nothing because those firefighters might be traveling into a life-threatening situation. And it's something we should all be aware of as we go through the day, that we have heroes in our midst.
You're absolutely right, Jane. You're live there at Ground Zero in New York City. I remember the first time my husband, a firefighter, walked into a building, a burning building, and disappeared in the smoke. It's just, it really brings it home that they're all of our brothers and our neighbors at that. Thank you.